Terry from Shades of Doom, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make a lovely Easter wreath, one that you can hang on your door or inside or use as a centerpiece. Now, because we're all under lockdown and sort of stuck at home at the moment, I'm trying to use as basic materials as possible because we can't just pop down to a local florist or a shop and buy bits and bobs. So what we're going to be using are basic twigs. I've got some lovely sort of bendy branches. I've got some blossoms, little blossom twigs, and some more woody sort of thicker stems. You can use vines, anything you find. Now, for decoration, what I've got is some feathers, which you can get in any Euro store or some supermarkets, I even stock in them at the moment, and a few little colorful eggs, these little hangers on them. You can use ribbons, bows, anything you want, even a few real Easter eggs if you like. I've got a bit of greenery here as well, just some lovely trailing ivy and a few bits of honeysuckle. Right, and you need a clippers and scissors and a little bit of tape. Now I'm using florist tape, but you can use any masking tape or electrical tape, whichever you have handy, and a few little wires. If you don't have wires or tape, you can use twine or any sort of rope, anything that you can get your hands on. Right, so to start off, we're going to make the frame. Now, most wreaths, you would actually buy a metal frame or you'd have a ready-made frame, but because we can't, at the moment, we're just going to go all natural. So I've got these twigs that are really kind of bendy. If you can get really long ones that can bend all the way around and give you a nice shape, you can use those. But I find it easy just to use two lots. So you take your two pieces like that, and we're just going to attach them at the top here. And I'm going to use tape, just because it's easy and quick. So just a couple of pieces of tape. You want quite a strong tape, so if you're using masking tape, a good one. Or you could just tie that. Right, so that's the top done. And don't worry about the tape sticking out because we'll deal with that later when we decorate. Now you're going to catch the bottom half. So we're just going to bend them. Same idea. Sort of a kind of a roundish shape. See over there. And I'm going to put some tape around the base. This is just our first layer. We're going to layer different twigs and branches onto my frame. It doesn't have to be neat or tidy, rustic and wild is all good. Now, as you can see, that's almost the shape of an Easter egg already. It doesn't have to be perfectly round, but as we go, it'll bend into shape. Now I'm going to take a couple of other twigs. These little blossoms are lovely because they give a nice sort of, and I'm just going to attach over there. It doesn't matter if they're sticking out of it. It'll be good just to hang your eggs off. Right. And we're going to keep going. And we'll take a few more twigs. As you can see, we're going around the ring. Now, using twigs or wire, I tend to go between the two. And see how the bits stick out in the end, which is fine. Keep going. And some more. We're going to work our way all the way around. And you can use some thicker twigs if you like. Give it a bit more. Make it look a bit bulkier. So you get the idea, you're actually just going to keep putting twigs all the way around. And I've got a few bigger, you could use conkers. And just there. Even you can actually get some nice vines hanging around. Or dried ivy vines are great. Anything you think is nice and you'd like to use. You could use white blossom trees, branches. We're going to keep going with our shape. Now, just to save a bit of time, I actually did one earlier. This one here, just to show you. And So what I've done is I've just kept going with the twigs all the way around, and you've got, see all the bits sticking out? It's really kind of rustic and natural looking. There's no top or bottom really, we just whichever way you like to hang it, you can hang it. Now, what I'd like to do is add a bit of greenery onto it. So I'm going to take some of my honey blossom, and you're just going to intertwine it through the layers. You don't really even need to use tape for these bits because you've got quite a nice base already. And it just gives you that lovely little bit of green going through it. Get some of these. I find the honeysuckle really, it's just starting now this time of year, but it's got a lovely texture and it actually will last for a couple of days as well. So I'm just going to pop these in here. And don't worry, you know, if you can't really judge at this stage, you can always, once it's on the wall or on the door, you can just adjust it if you need to. Now there's a few ivy, bits of ivy as well. That'll give it a nice kind of texture. And again, I'm just going to push those through. And maybe one at the bottom. Just along that line. So there, you've already got some green. If you want to put some flowers in, you could put some tulips in. Same way, you can just kind of thread them through, although you'd want to just put the tulips in probably just the day before Easter, just so they last. I'm going with a nice kind of rustic, greeny, sort of woodlandy look. Right, and now for decoration. Okay, so here we have our... Now, I've got these feathers. I just bought a bag of feathers. And I've literally just wired the base there. So just put a cluster together and pinch them and then just wire it around it. Now I'm going to just put a few of these around. I like the bits of yellow and a bit of colour. It just gives it a real little Easter feel. And you just wind them around. It's a great thing to do with your kids actually. I took my two out this morning for a walk and that's where we found all these lovely branches. And it's nice just to have a bit of colour, and even though we're stuck at home and we can't go anywhere or do anything, at least we can brighten up our own homes and feel good for Easter. Right, and now all that's left is just to hang our Easter eggs. So, and because you've got this kind of free-flowing, wild sort of look, you've got plenty of little branches to hang your eggs on too. So, start here. And I think one or two of my eggs went missing actually. Little hands have been in these baskets of mine. Go. And anywhere you see a little space that could do with a pop of colour on the side. And surprise actually what you can find in your own garden. And if you just go for a little walk, and then, there's two colours right next to each other, so we'll just spread them out rather. We're lucky in Ireland, at least we can go for a 2 kilometre walk, so you can find a lot within 2 kilometres of your home, especially around Kerry. And the last one. Your rustic, natural,